Like I said earlier, I do not get many things in life right the first time around, but I definitely got the temples of Angkor right. Day one, hire a tuk-tuk, catch the sunrise at Angkor Wat, zip around the grounds, don't lose your ticket, see some cool stuff, and plot out which temples you want to circle back to the next day. Day two, rent a badass bike and explore the main temple area on your own. The three we fell for were Angkor Wat, Angkor Thom, and Taprom. Be sure to bring a guidebook so you know exactly what ancient ruins you're looking at, because trust me, they are way more interesting if you actually know what you're looking at. Then day three, rent that same badass bike and get out of town. Like, actually out of town. About a two-hour bike ride from the main temple complex is a gorgeously ornate temple called Bentie Shrine. Considered by many the finest piece in the Angkor collection, the carvings and reliefs look more like they belong on the side of a decorative jewelry box than on the side of an exposed to the elements temple. They say that this temple must have been built by women because the elaborate artwork is too fine to have been done by the hands of man, which is fitting because Bentie Shrine means Citadel of the Women. There is a pond with green lily pads and grasses that's a stunning contrast to the red sandstone surrounding and adds the otherworldly effect. It's not a large temple, but because of how intricate every piece is, it could still take hours to explore if you really want to get into it. I could have stayed here forever, but my camera gear had a different idea. So after 3 solid days of temple hopping, my GoPro batteries and my memory card had it. So we hopped back on our bikes, headed back to town, found the perfect spot for sunset, drank an Angkor beer, and called a wrap on 3 perfect days in Angkor. Coming up next is the last video of the Angkor series. Yeah, did I ever tell you about the monkeys in Angkor?
They're coming after you. That was terrifying.